Welcome to the module on basics of concrete. Today we will be discussing about the steam curing. So once again, just to remind each one of you, what is curing? Curing is the process of controlling the rate and extent of moisture loss from the concrete during the hydration of cement. And the hydration starts as soon as the cement gets in contact with water. So ideally, one should start curing as soon as the concrete has taken its shape in the form of various members or elements of a structure. Probably it can be a beam, it can be a column, slab, whatever it is. So the different methods of curing, if you see, there are various methods of curing. The adoption of a particular method will depend upon the nature of work and the climatic conditions. In general, any application which stops a loss of moisture from concrete surface will act as a curing. When we talk about different methods of curing, we have water curing, which is again further divided into three types like immersion, ponding, sprinkling. This we have discussed in the first module and covering with moist fabric. Then in the previous module, we talked about some of the important points to be considered in case of a membrane curing. Today we will be discussing the steam curing, and in the next upcoming modules, we will be covering the heat curing, covering the concrete elements with polythene sheet or curing with impervious papers, and partly for the direct electrical curing. So what is meant by a steam curing? Steam curing is a process for hardening concrete, cement and mortar that involves exposure to warm steams. Materials subject to this hardening techniques tends to cure more uniformly and also much more quickly than those hardened via other processes. The objective of steam curing, if you see, the primary objective of steam curing is to develop a higher yield strength of the concrete so that concrete products can be removed from the formwork and handled as early as possible and mainly adopted in the precast works. As chemical reaction of hydration of cement can be thermally activated, increased rate of strength development of concrete is achieved by restoring to the steam curing at atmospheric temperatures. Depending upon the temperature level at which the element is being maintained, the efficiency or the strength arriving early, the time period to reach the early strength will depend upon. So depending upon the requirements, the curing temperature can be maintained and the duration of the curing also can be maintained. So typically, steam curing is having three stages. One is the pre-curing period. Second is the rate of increase or decrease of temperature in the curing chamber, that is in the form of a steam. Then level and time of constant temperatures, so that one has to maintain. Too high rate of increase or decrease in the temperature introduces thermal shocks. Therefore, the rate of increase or decrease in the temperature should be in the range of 10 to 20 degrees centigrade per hour, and a level of 70 degrees as a constant temperature is sufficient for most of the curing. It can be a lesser degree also, depending upon the grade of the concrete and the requirement, like what is the percentage of strength which you want to achieve as compared to the 28 day strength. Sometimes probably maybe at a lower temperature also you will be able to achieve the required strength. So the trials needs to be conducted at different temperatures in order to make sure that what is the optimum temperature at which you are able to achieve the required strength so that the subsequent activities can be taken care of. So this is a typical cycle of steam curing as given in SP23. There you can see that you have a straight line which is defining about the pre-steaming period of around 3 hours. Then you have a line which is designated by B, that is the rise in temperature for 2.5 hours at a rate of 10 to 20 degrees centigrade per hour. since the graph shows that in this particular case it is around 20 degrees centigrade per hour, so that the temperature, which was initially 30 to 40, has gone up to 80-85. And then the line C, it defines about the maximum temperature or the maximum period for which the temperature has to be maintained, and then you have a cooling period for around 5 to 6 hours. But it is a representative element matter as far as the curing cycle is concerned. But in your case, you need to draw the lines once again in order to understand that what is the maximum time period which you can have so that you will achieve the required strength, and then what should be the rate of increase or rate of decrease of temperature. So based on that, you can arrive at an optimum time cycle of steam curing to the tune of 14 to 16 hours. In steam curing, objects to be cured are placed inside a chamber or a room, or using a control panel, an operator can set the temperature and the humidity level as shown in the typical examples. The member or the element is being covered with a thick tarpaulin sheet so that there won't be any loss of steam, which is ultimately resulting in the drop in temperature inside the chamber portion where the concrete element is being placed. So the idea is the efficiency of the steam curing depends a lot on the temperature which is being maintained uniformly throughout the period of steaming, so that equal amount of rate of increase in the strength of elements can be observed for different elements placed at different chambers. The temperatures can be monitored for each cell and adjusted by increasing or decreasing the flow of steam in the particular chamber to maintain the desired levels. This is very important because this is actually showing you the temperature at which the design has been done for that particular element, because the concrete during the design stage, what is that temperature at which it is being cured is the same temperature one has to maintain when executing the work in the field. Otherwise, the results which you have got during the design mix stage, probably you will not be able to get the same results during the execution in the field. So the temperature monitoring of steam curing is the most important factor, and one has to take care effectively during the complete cycle of steam curing. Variation in pressure may also be possible. Depending upon the device, the heat and the moisture penetrates the materials quickly to fully hydrate and harden the elements which are being kept for steam curing. Steam curing requires a fraction of time involved with the traditional curing and quickly strengthens the products so they can be used immediately. After steam curing, water curing is required, because without doing proper water curing, the strength gain will be lost during the 28 days compressive strength. You can do water curing, or and alternatively you can apply the membrane curing also over the element which is being cured using the steam curing. The brush applications on both the sides so that the rate of application of the curing compound can be maintained. These things were elaborated in detail in my previous module, where we discussed about the effectiveness of the membrane curing and how the rate of spray of the membrane curing can be maintained. The advantages of steam curing is for precasting elements, the time for concrete to attain strength required or strength considered as ideal time. If this time is minimized, we can have more precast elements produced in less time duration. That means to optimize the production at the precast units, you need to minimize the strength gain timing so that the waiting period can be reduced for the subsequent activities. And this is the major key in order to maintain or in order to increase the productivity of the precast units one should go for the steam curing. By adopting proper steam curing cycle, more than 70% of the strength of 28 days compressive strength of concrete can be obtained in 14 to 16 hours. Hence, steam curing is always helpful for precasting units, because without increasing the resources, without increasing the manpower, just by reducing the waiting time to dismantle or remove the formwork from the precast elements, you are able to increase the productivity. And that is possible because of the steam curing, because steam curing will give you the opportunity to increase the early strength in many folds. Almost 70% of the strength, as discussed, you are getting in 14 to 16 hours, which normally one takes 7 days in order to achieve 70% of strength if you adopt normal curing methods. The limitations of steam curing, if you see, steam curing should be followed by water curing or any other method of curing for at least 7 days. Because in the absence of water curing or any other alternative methods of curing, the strength of elements which have increased during the early stage are being reduced by 20 to 40% than the normally cured concrete at 28 days compressive strength. So in the absence of effective normal curing, the 28 days compressive strength shows a marginal decrease in the strength. So if you see the graph which is being demonstrated in SP23, typically you can see that you have three stages. One is the standard curing method. Then second line in the center, in the bottom center, you can see that it is resembling steam curing followed by water curing. And then the third one, which is having a horizontal lines in the box, shows that steam curing is followed by drying at 20 degrees centigrade and 65% humidity levels. Now, in this particular graph, there are two parameters were shown. One is the change in compressive strength, and the second is the change in flexural strength with respect to the peak temperature maintained and the duration of the temperature being maintained. So, if the peak temperature is 80 and the duration is 2 hours, then you can see a drop in strength from 100 to 70, or you can say it is between 60 and 70, so maybe say 70. But when it is 2 hours 45 minutes of duration, then the 100% strength is reduced to 85% or 80% strength. And when the temperature is 80 and the duration is 3.5 hours, then the max, again the 28 days compressive strength is being reduced to 60 out of 100 when steam curing is not followed by any other alternate methods of curing. So this shows that when the steam curing is alone is not sufficient in order to make sure that you will be able to get the required strength even after the 28 days compressive strength. But when the peak temperature is reduced, like from 80 to 60, then the drop in strength from steam curing followed by water curing and steam curing without following by water curing is not that that significant. Whereas if you see the flexural strength, even in the flexural strength also, if you see the standard curing as 100% and you are maintaining a temperature of 80 degrees for a duration of 2 hours, then your flexural strength is 95% when followed with water curing, and flexural strength is 70% when not followed by water curing, as shown in the top left box in the flexural strength box. Similarly, when you move from left to right, you can see that your flexural strength goes on decreasing for 2 hours 45 minutes. But for 3.5 hours at a temperature of peak temperature of 80 degrees, your flexural strength is equal to the standard curing elements. But your flexural strength is reduced to 70% when the steam curing is not followed by your water curing. So this is how the impact of steam curing is In a nutshell, one can summarize that steam curing alone is not sufficient to give the element the complete required strength for a longer duration of time. Instantly, it will definitely give you higher strength, but later on, if it is not followed by water curing or any other approved methods of curing, then probably the 28-day strength is going to be reduced by almost 40% of the as compared to the normal curing method adopted. Therefore, it is always recommended to follow your water curing or any other methods of curing immediately after completing the steam curing cycle. Steam curing cycle, as per ASTO, if you see the stage or the stages of steam curing is divided in four cycles, as it was there in IS standards. For initial temperature of more than or equal to 10 degrees, the preheating is being maintained for 2 hours. Thereafter, the stage 2 starts, where the temperature can be increased or decreased at the rate of 22 degrees centigrade per hour to a maximum temperature of 70, and that maximum temperature should be less than or equal to 70 degrees as per ASTO or PCI. Then that particular duration, is which is stage 3, is being maintained in this particular case for 10 hours, that is 4 to 14 hours. After 14 hours, the cooling period starts, which is again last for 2 hours at the rate of 22 degrees centigrade per hour in case of ASTO and 15 degrees centigrade per hour in case of CSA. And after completing the cooling period, again the elements are being placed in that particular condition for another 2 hours to stabilize themselves. So whether it is IS or it is ASTO or ASTM, the average cycle time for steam curing is lying in between 14 to 18 hours, because the duration and the temperature at which the maximum peak temperature shall be maintained depends upon the strength what is required or targeted, and based on that strength at a different temperatures you can make trials for your concrete and then see what strength you are getting. So to summarize this module, in this particular module we talked about the definition of curing, we talked about the definition of steam curing, the objectives of steam curing, the advantages of steam curing, and also the limitations of steam curing. Why water curing is important followed by steam curing, and what will happen if the water curing is not done followed by steam curing to the particular element as far as the compressive strength or the flexural strength at 28 days is concerned. In the next upcoming modules, we will be discussing about the heat curing in detail. Thank you very much for watching. Tune in for more updates.